This is a global Tel-Link prepaid call from
Mindy Proje,
a medical student at Queen's Medical School.
From the Queen's Med class of 2020, this is the interview video. I'm Lena Koenig, an MD-PhD student at Queen's. For the last year, I've spent every working day trying to find a person with a very rare condition. It has an acronym, SMGA-HIC. Honestly, who comes up with these acronyms? People with SGA-HIC experience the world around them as if it were a musical. Some people don't believe me, but I have evidence. I found a few anecdotal reports and one case caught on tape of a high school student with the condition. After a year of searching, that was the only reliable case I could find. That is, until now.
What did you say?
Oh, nothing.
Is this on? Okay, good.
Hi, Mindy. Congratulations on finishing your first year of medical school.
My name is Lana, and I'm so happy to finally meet you. My PhD thesis was doomed until today, and it's been so hard to find funding, and my supervisor thinks I'm crazy for going down this rabbit hole, and...
Focus, Lana. You're on the home stretch.
Hi. Before we start, I just want to remind you that everything you say is completely confidential. Except for the stuff that I think is absolutely perfect for my documentary. Okay, great. So I've looked at the form you filled out, and it seems like you're an excellent candidate for my study. I mean, it sounds like you're concerned about your health.
Yeah, I kind of think there's something wrong with me.
Okay, how do you mean exactly?
Well, it's like I get this sudden and generalized auditory experience. It's kind of like a high school musical, idiopathic feeling. Like everything around me is a musical. But sometimes, it's pretty cool.
I see. So, when did this all start for you?
Oh, I'll never forget that. It actually started here at Queen's last winter during the interview weekend.
You can do this. It's just an interview.
Talented and enthusiastic they are, and I had trouble keeping track of what was real and what wasn't. But when it kept happening, I started to realize something strange was going on. My tour of the amazing new medical building started out pretty normally.
Hey, my name's Greg. Our tour's about to start, so gather around.
But then the tour guide said something, and it just made me think.
You ready, group? Start walking.
I keep saying QMed is something for you. Something that you'll love and that's no lie. Lab dissections, normal human structure. Lecture theaters, take a look inside. Trauma's in the sim lab, and clinical skills practice too. In no time you'll find that QMed is the place for you.
Did you not just see that?
Yeah, I thought it was a great tour.
They have cool lockers.
Jean shorts. 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 Right. Fascinating. I can see this vision is clearly upsetting you, so let's just move on. How was the interview itself?
Don't even ask.
Everyone thought I was crazy during those interviews.
I'm sure they did. Did you have any more episodes that day after your interview?
Oh yeah, that's when I met Dr. Sanfilippo.
Coast of Lake Ontario, between Montreal and Toronto, we're the finest selection, world-class research reflects in Keene School of Medicine, where our stars are shining bright, not just the ones you see at night. Well, I've searched so long for this cool spirit and found Keene School of Medicine. Oh, Keene School of Medicine. Oh, our School of Medicine. We're excited to meet you. Look around, see what we do at Queen's School of Medicine. Well, I looked from coast to coast and saw what other schools bought. O's. Our international ties will leave you feeling inspired. Give me Queen's School of Medicine.
Sanfilippo. What a guy.
Yeah, and he's been a really supportive dean. I mean, I didn't even know we had a dean during my undergrad.
Okay, let's switch gears. Did you go to any of the social events that weekend?
Yeah. At that point, I was starting to get a handle on this whole med school musical thing. That was a big turning point for me. And this one girl who ended up in my class this year, she got really into it. Or at least, I think she did.
It feels like a perfect night for med house parties. If I'm love with QMed, tomorrow feels like a perfect day to dress up my position. I hope I get in. Yeah, we're happy, free, confused, and stressed at the same time. Unbelievable and magical, oh yeah. Tonight's the night when we forget about the MCAT. It's time. Oh oh. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling queen's med. You, everything will be alright if I learn to keep my cool. You know about me, but I bet you want to. Everything will be alright if we just keep acting like.
This is excellent material for my documentary. And it's great that you overcame this challenge and got accepted to QMed. So, how has SJHAC affected you as a medical student?
It was really difficult for me at first. I was so nervous going to school every day, afraid it might come back during a lecture, or worse, during an exam, or with a standardized patient in our fabulous clinical teaching center.
Wow. Tell me more.
Sometimes family med class got very strange during the break.
Okay, guys, any more questions from the class? Okay, good. Well, that's our first hour done. Let's take a family med break. All right.
Learning clinical skills could get a bit awkward.
That pulse is bumping.
Pump up the jam, pump it up while your feet are stumping. And the jam is pumping. Look ahead, the crowd is jumping. Pump it up a little more, get the party going on the dance floor. See, cause that's where the party's at, and you find out if you do that.
I want a place to stay, get your booty on.
And exams were interesting.
Mindy, this is OSCE winning material.
Yeah, it was really hard for me.
Yeah, that must have been very hard for you.
That's what I just said. But you know, even though it could be challenging, it ended up being a pretty cool way to see the world. And my classmates and teachers have been so supportive. More and more, I realize QMed is the place for me.
Wait, but I haven't come to the conclusion yet. When I first began my investigation of subject number 2, aka Mindy Proje, I was convinced that Eschahak needed to be treated for patients like Mindy to live a normal life. I realize now that I was wrong. In the right setting, the things that make us different become our strength. When each of us is valued for the unique perspective we bring, we can overcome any challenge. Sure, Queen's Med School has top-notch facilities, unique hands-on clinical opportunities, and really dedicated teachers. But most importantly, Mindy found her community, her family. We can't wait to meet you next year. Eschahak and all.
Oh my God!
Oh my God!